Hi guys, it's Karen. Today I am participating, sort of, in a challenge that I actually had on my radar since Halloween. And I had plans for this challenge. And everything went awry. I don't know if you remember my Halloween doll, but I had bought this... silver-haired doll, and I knew that the Ghost Doll Challenge and a Lord of the Rings Challenge was going to be happening in the end at the end of February. So I thought, okay, I don't want to keep a ghost doll permanently. So what I'll do is I'll get a second faceplate and I will make the ghost doll, and then I'll get a new faceplate and new eyes, and I'll put it on this doll, and she'll be my Lord of the Rings doll. Because I can take on, and I have some couple fairy dolls, so I could use her ears. I wouldn't have to buy extra ears, yada, yada, yada. So, and I have her body and everything. It's right here. I can't find her eyes. I don't know what I did with her eyes. I don't even know if I ordered her eyes. I'd have to go back and look. I'm pretty sure I ordered extra eyes. But then what the hell did I do with them? Yeah, so that's a problem. Because I've been sick practically. I was sick November. I was sick. So October 31st, we did the Ghost Doll Challenge. Then I was sick November, December, and January. And now my son has another sore throat. So I expect I'll be sick soon here in March, the end of February. So yeah, so things have gotten really away from me. And then I thought, well, I'll just use Odette because she looks like, this is a Takara Odette from like 2018, 2019, 2020, somewhere in there. And she was my first legit Takara, or my legit Blythe. So I had the Resonant and Rapture free pattern, which I love to use. And I thought, okay, I'll square off the neckline, because I looked at a lot of, I'm a huge Lord of the Rings book fan. And of course, I also have seen all the movies several times. And most of the elves in the movies, they wear really pale, earthy colors. And I was going with silver, and the cloaks that they give to the travelers were like a gray that hid them. And I had ordered some ribbon at the time. I ordered this fabric off of Amazon. I had ordered some ribbon that I was going to trim it with, and I was going to turn into a belt because I had to drop the waist of the pattern. So I was going to have it all trimmed with this like decorative ribbon and it didn't come. I paid for it. It said it shipped. It was not in the package with the other thing. So I got a refund on that. Then I thought, okay, well, maybe I have some like jewels or beads. Maybe I'll decorate it with that instead. And I had gone ahead and adapted a sleeve pattern so that I was hoping it would drape more like a medieval dress. And I sewed this on inside out. So at that point, I was just like, I can't deal with this anymore. So I just finished the dress. And even though I carefully measured it, it is, I measured it like with my tape measure, with this measure, I measured everything to lengthen everything by a quarter of an inch and a quarter of an inch, and it's still too short. And the sleeve bells aren't long enough. I wanted them a lot more belled. So here's the takeaways that I am very happy about with this. I did my typical facing method of getting a squared off collar, and it bunches in the corners. So if I were to make another squared off collar, I probably want to try to get some kind of a placard facing. And there's a ton of stuff for like real people stuff on YouTube. So I might have to look into that, but I do like that I can adjust the size. I can adjust the shape with this pattern. I can adjust, like I could make a V-neck dress, which I really kind of want to do now. This with a belt, like I was going to put a low-hanging belt. I like this lower waist on her, on my, oh God, where is it now? On my mannequin, my Takara-style mannequin, which was just right here. I have like places taped off so that I can adjust patterns on it. Oh, I can't show you now because she's missing in action. And I like the full length. Like, I would like to make this, I would actually like to make this with just the normal, you know, like a make a maxi dress based on that pattern. So, and I think that the sleeves were easy enough to modify. So I just have to go like go big or go home next time. If I want to turn this into a medieval dress, I could even go lower here, a little tad lower here. And the back is, I think the reason this is messed up is because I had done one back whole half inch lower, one back panel, one whole half inch lower than the other one. So we're not even going to talk about that. I kind of pinned it up in the back so that it was not messed up. But she looks really pretty. The other thing about the Lord of the Rings elves is their ears are very small and you don't always see them out. So I wasn't really too concerned with either doll about having the elf ears, but I did have a pair if I wanted to stick them on her. So, yeah. So I, you know, I don't like, we commit to these collabs and I'd rather show you what didn't go well to let those of you who have goof ups and stuff know that you're not alone. I fought with the sleeves. That is like my one weakness in sewing is setting in or sewing on sleeves. I was not about to rip this off for the second time and freaking turn it inside out and do it correctly. I was like, here you can see that I've used pinking shears to finish my edges so that they won't fray fast. And if you don't know what those are, they're scissors with this serrated blade that makes triangles. Really handy to have. I finish a lot of my hems that way. And this would have looked really so pretty with the trim on the cuffs and right around the neckline and then the belt that I was going to do, but alas. So I'm really excited to go see what everybody else did. I know there's quite a few people in the challenge. If I can get a hold of the list, I will include it in the link below. I believe I know where that is. And I hope that you guys all had a great time. A lot of the other people in the challenge also did custom dolls. I am sort of overdoing custom dolls right now, and I'm just trying to use the dolls that I have. And like I said, I did plan, I was going to do special eye chips for this doll and, you know, just a basic custom with just eyelids and eye chips. But again, that did not pan out. So I still have to put this doll together. And, yeah, I love Odette though. She makes a perfect elf and I'm always happy to see her. I can't help it. I like a basic pale blonde. I don't know why. So I will go see everybody else. Let me know in the comments below if you don't talk about it in your video. Did you have any problems with this challenge or did you guys all just rock it out of the park? All right. I'll see you guys soon in the comment sections. Bye.